We have a tractor trailer with a 53-foot trailer that had some sort of a structural issue. All right, let's go see what we got.
That load's gonna buckle.
Oh, it's broken.
I'm like, holy crap, how did this guy manage to do this? Here we have a trailer that is broken right in the middle. It looks like a big banana here on the highway.
Wall's already been breached both sides, so the structural integrity of this trailer is gone.
The semi is loaded with almost 50,000 pounds of paper. It was heading southbound when the trailer caved in without warning, sending the truck careening down the highway.
It took a chunk of asphalt out of the road there as well, so.
Sergeant Kerry Schmidt and other members of the Ontario Provincial Police need to figure out why the trailer collapsed.
Looking at this, it's a bit of a mystery. Was the trailer overloaded? Was there a maintenance issue? Was it an old defective trailer? There's still a lot of issues we need to figure out.
Actually, Paul, scoot one under. Just make sure nobody's there. One's for the other side.
James can't risk towing the severely damaged trailer with a heavy load still inside.
The paper rolls apparently are pretty tall. We don't even know yet because we haven't seen them. We don't want one falling over and coming out a wall, or the bottom of the trailer giving out and collapsing.
He'll have to unload. His first move, shore up the broken frame.
There's gonna be a lot of weight in here, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna rig it up with the rotator, and we're gonna lift the belly of the trailer up a bit to try and get some of the weight off it. The back will come back down on the ground, and we're gonna start pulling the product right at the back. So if you guys wanna take this over there and just assemble it, the ends go on, make sure they're both pointing the same direction. Putting the spreader bar together so we can put it over the trailer and lift both sides at the same time. Yeah, these are gonna go
in here.
Okay, a 10-foot chain down each side now. What we'll do is we'll just take one end and then swing it over, okay?
The spreader bar over the top.
We're gonna pull it over, right?
Well, we should be able to put it over.
We'll connect with the chains running under the damaged belly in an attempt to keep the floor from ripping apart.
We've put some angle iron underneath with a couple of blocks so we don't rip the chains through the floor.
But with no idea what caused the damage, James can't be sure any rigging will be enough.
Both walls are pulled inwards. Usually when they collapse in the middle, the walls go out. So it's gonna be a bit of a mystery here to find out what happened. I haven't seen this happen before. Lord only knows what's caused this thing to collapse like this.
With a storm blowing in from Georgian Bay.
That should be okay.
James Ireland and the crew from Classic Towing need to clear the collapsed trailer from the 400 fast.
We definitely don't want to be out here when the weather hits.
Hey guys, heads up.
But the semi is so damaged, even securing it for the offload could rip it apart.
All we want to do is make the trailer come back into the position it used to be without tearing it.
Our biggest concern right now is the trailer actually breaking. That would be bad. Well, here we go, thumbs up. It'll make lots of noise. It's in a safe state. We're gonna open the back doors and take a look inside. Just be careful in case the door springs. On skids. We're just over 2,000 pounds per lift. Okay, guys, heads up.
James wants to be off the road before the weather hits, but they can't rush the process.
If one of these rolls ever fell out the back and rolled out onto the highway, a car could hit this. It's the same weight as a car, so it's gonna be like a head-on collision.
As they load the cargo into a new trailer, the OPP is watching for any sign of what caused the mystery collapse.
Is it overloaded? There's something in the middle of that trailer that has forced its structural support to collapse.
And as the crew digs deeper into the load,
there's a culprit.
They get their first clue.
Ooh. That's a lot of weight, that snow. You can see inside the trailer here now. There's a huge amount of snow right in the center where the trailer collapsed. It's pushed everything in, sucked the walls in, and the floor's gone out.
So there was no issues with the load, there's no issues with the maintenance of the trailer.
You see the amount of snow up there? It's a huge ball. Mother Nature's fault, this one.
What we know is that the load of snow on top of the trailer collapsed the roof, and then the structural integrity of the trailer was completely lost.
Yeah, it just kind of stayed to the sides, yeah.
To pull out the last of the pallets, a member of the crew will have to venture right into the back of the trailer.
It's a huge ball. Thousands of pounds there.
Gotta watch the snow in the roof so it doesn't cave anymore. Stay off to the sides of it now. That way we don't get hurt.
Paul pulled the short straw today, so he's the one that gets to work inside the trailer with this big ball of ice hanging over top of his head.
This is what I'm scared about. Okay, you might want to stand back. This one, it hits the wall there.
Go ahead. Hang on. Okay, go. There you go.
That roof's getting more dicey and dicey.
Perfect.
They've emptied the last of the load. But now the crew has to clear the ice pushing on the roof.
You can feel the weight in the trailer as he's poking the roof. It's a crazy amount of weight up there.
You know, Paul's got to be very careful while he's moving around inside this trailer.
You good? You feel it come up as soon as you did that? What a difference, eh?
Now James needs to get it ready to tow.
Grab me a couple shovels and a couple guys.
But the storm is blowing in fast.
To the north of us, there's some freezing rain and snow, so pressure's on now.
We're seeing really kind of snowing here. Out of nowhere, man, it's just snowing like crazy.
Right now, as we speak, we're just getting snow coming down. We've got a freezing rain advisory coming in. Big puffy flakes, we're gonna have reduced visibility. We could have slippery roads on this as well. So just as weather comes in, we've gotta get out of here and we gotta get this highway open.
We probably got a centimeter of snow here already in the last 10 minutes. And look at the traffic going by. It's still doing highway speeds, you know? We're getting the hell out of here because if not, somebody's gonna end up getting hurt.